Hello, everybody. I read a lot of comments that I am the rice for PCs, and I just wanted to clear that up. For those of you new to this channel, it must be known, I will rice anything, even an old fire stick. You may remember that little heat magnet everybody went bananas for, just to run Cody at a snail's pace. I drilled some much needed holes in mine, and hey, it works even better than ever. Amazingly cool, but unfortunately everybody has a fire stick story. So today, guess what? We are restoring a PC. So sit back while I clean up another old HP.
What we do here is go back.
The only difference between these two HP small form factors, besides hardware and software, are 2 days of restorations and upgrades. Yes, it's true, dirt and all, but with my keen ricer vision and Linux operating system, this DC7800 cried for help and wanted to regain some of his 2007 love and respect. So show that old PC or whatever catches your eye and give it some well-deserved respect. Are you liking what you're seeing so far? Well, go ahead, come on, join the community. A thorough cleansing, a little scuffing, and just a scotch of Krylon Fusion spray paint? Hey, I say we put this thing back together, what do you think? We'll be right back. LCD screen adds a nice touch to the build, but it has limited resolution and you have to be looking dead at it. It has HDMI and was made for a Raspberry Pi. So I just ran the cords out the back, one for the 5-volt USB, and the other HDMI cord plugged up to the back of a GT1030. I used a Dremel to cut up the front panel, thinking this would be an easy peasy mod. I separated the control board from the monitor, but with the flex cable ribbon being so short and HDMI position being on top, this was not the best screen to use for this particular PC. But I made do. Let's see how the rest of the restoration went. Before you can upgrade operating systems or processors on this particular system, make sure you do update the BIOS. You can find all this information on HP's website by model, or because some other boards are revisions, there's a serial number usually printed on the board itself. And those numbers, when Googled, will show you what you're working with. I'm dual booting Linux Mint and Windows 10. Mint has a great Windows-like interface and picked up the NVIDIA GT1030 rather easy. And it provided me with the correct driver download. So I'm thinking, hey, great Steam machine. That is about enough for me. I hope you enjoyed this video. There might be a follow-up, not sure yet, but what I am sure of is the Budget Builder. He's doing some really cool stuff over there, and I hope you'll check him out. I'll leave a link in the description. He's got some neat ideas, and he's really talented.